Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I've got my next super exciting update for my Pan That palette for 2019, which is the ABH Subculture palette. I've made so much awesome progress this month. I just felt so inspired, and I just did so good, and I'm so proud of myself, and I'm so happy with where we are now. So before we jump into my update for right now, I'm looking a little dark for summer. Black brows, pretty much black hair, black lipstick. I'm in the middle of testing lipsticks for my upcoming black lipstick video. I really want to get up right before October or early October. Today I am wearing a MAC color. This is the retro matte lip color in the shade Caviar. And I have to say, I'm not a huge fan of like the applicator on this. I felt like it was hard to get a crisp line, which is what you really need with a black lipstick. So I felt like it wasn't as precise, like at the corners of my mouth, and then especially up on the cupid's bow. But it's my first time wearing it, so I'm gonna see how it actually performs and how comfortable it is, because right now I'm still feeling a bit like a sticky. So we shall see about that. And also my hair is still drying, guys, so it's gonna look like this. Let's go ahead and start the slideshow of what my palette has looked like over the past over half a year of updates. This is my palette now. Oh my god, can you even believe this? Look how big the pan is in Rowdy. Also, I broke my nail. I gotta fix that. Look how big the pan is in Rowdy. Look how big it is in Edge. I also, amazingly, hit pan in Mercury. I also hit pan in Fudge. And I hit pan in Destiny. So I've got pan in three new shades. Is that not incredible? And also, I was able to use up half of what's remaining of Electric right here. You can see there's no more product on the top part of the pan. It's all on the bottom. And Dawn is completely gone. It's the first shade in this palette that I've been able to completely use up. Because if you saw my intro, you'll know that I wasn't able to get use out of Cube, so I depotted and got rid of Cube before I started panning this palette, which makes Dawn my first full completed shade. And I honestly don't think Electric and Rowdy are gonna be far behind. I am so proud of myself. This is, I think, the most amount of progress that I've seen in a single month with this palette. Pan on three more shades, a shade totally used up, because I mentioned in my last update that I was a bit worried about how my progress was going to be, because I still hadn't used up a full shade yet. Just used up a full shade. And honestly, like I said, I don't think it's gonna be long before I finish up Electric and before I finish up Rowdy, because like I said, I've been using Rowdy in my brows every day, including today, and it's just been working really well for me. So I'm gonna use the Rowdy until it's gone, and I might be able to use Mercury in my brows next, actually. Tested it out once and it didn't look bad, so might do that. I think the main reason why I've been able to make such great progress this month is I've like redoubled down, and I've really been forcing myself to go outside of my comfort zone. I've been looking up tutorials with Subculture, I've been looking up pictorials, I've been on Instagram and Pinterest just looking up different looks, watching different videos, getting inspired. So I've also been doing all of that research and testing out new looks. I've also been bringing in other palettes to work with Subculture, and that really helps, especially now that I'm actually about to finish get rid of the second shimmer shade. So I'm only gonna have one shimmer shade left. So I found it was really helpful to bring in other palettes. The best one that's been working for me, I'm actually wearing on my eyes with Subculture today, is the Too Faced Chocolate Gold palette, which is majority shimmer, and the shades are actually quite gorgeous. I'm wearing on my lid today the shade Rich Girl, and I've actually really been liking just applying shimmers and kind of blending and blowing them out just with my finger. I know, like, I haven't even been using NYX glitter glue. I've just kind of been looking for a more blown out kind of wispy look, and so I've actually loved applying these shades just with my finger all over the lid, and I think It's gorgeous. And it actually does last a full day, which, if you know me, you know I have very hooded lids, and I used to be like, oh, NYX glitter glue, you need it, it'll stay all day. But with these shadows, I've actually seen shadows stay and not crease just with applying my finger. So it's been amazing bringing this palette out. I'm getting a lot of use out of this. It's really making me reach for other shades in Subculture too. And I'm actually at the beginning, I'm filming this at the beginning of a long holiday. This is literally like July 3rd. So if you're in the US, it's 4th of July weekend. And since 4th of July is on a Thursday, we get Thursday and Friday off. And today, I'm filming this on Wednesday, is actually going to be a half day for work, which is nice. So I'm going to have plenty of time to do more experimenting. And I especially want to work with the more pinky red shades in here, Roxy and All Star, now that it is 4th of July. I could also do the blues too. I could do a red, white, and blue look. It's gonna be too late to film it, but I think I might do that for actual 4th of July. I've also been bringing in some other ABH palettes, like the new Alyssa Edwards palette and the Riviera palette, to work with this palette, but I found that I really prefer the Too Faced Chocolate Gold. It's a perfect companion palette for this, and it's just what I've been getting the most use out of. I find that I do my best work when I don't set goals for myself for the upcoming month, so I'm just gonna stick with that. I'm just gonna say, it'd be nice to use up those two shades, Rowdy and Electric, since there is so much pan, but I'm not gonna hold it against me if I don't, because I've been doing so well with this palette, because I feel like I hit my mid-year slump early. I feel like I hit that kind of around like April, and now I'm like full speed ahead. We're doing great. Ah. So thank you guys so much for your suggestions on my last video. I used a lot of suggestions that people left me for tutorials, for looks, for videos, and it really helped inspire me. So thank you guys for everyone who left, sent me a message, who commented. Very much appreciated. I appreciate this whole community and each and every one of you. Thank you guys for watching this update. Let me know down below if you're doing a Pan That palette, how it's going. Now that we're in July, we're past the halfway point. Thank you guys again for watching, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye.